Susanne has been the love of my life for over 40 years. How do you sum up 60 years of life in just a few words or sentences? Susanne was born February 5th, 1958 in Edmonton, Alberta. She was the oldest of three daughters born to Harold and Marie Dow. Harold owned Happy Creek Gas Station and Chainsaw Repair Garage in Hinton. Susanne recalls memories about going out fishing and four-wheel driving with her parents and sleeping under lean-tos in the bush as they had no tents. When Susanne was about 4 years old, she got into a little bit of trouble with her dad. Since he ran a gas station, he would often bring the cash from the register home every night. So one night, she saw the money sitting on the table and grabbed a pair of scissors and cut all the white frames off all the bills. Her dad was not happy. When Susanne was about 6 years old, her dad got the homesteading bug, packed up the family and moved north to Silver Valley, Fourth Creek area, where she grew up in the wilds of northern Alberta. Susanne was part of the first graduating class of Savannah School. I believe it was 9 students. Yep, pretty big class. Her first job after high school, like most girls back then, was becoming a tree planter for P&G. She had a great time doing this job and enjoyed the girls she worked with, but not the bears. The bears would often come into the cut blocks where they worked. One morning, as the girls were getting up and ready, they heard a lot of noise and then a gunshot. Then they looked outside and they saw that the cook had shot a bear on the steps to their trailer. Susanne attended the Grand Prairie Regional College in her pursuit to become a school teacher. While at the college, Susanne took part in many activities like canoeing and skiing. And yes, I did see the pictures to prove it was true. The next summer, she took a job at Wallace's Greenhouse in Beaver Lodge, working with my youngest brother, Brian. Brian played soccer in Beaver Lodge, so one day he asked me to come to the game and watch him play, and I said sure. Little did I know that he had asked Susanne to come and watch the same game. We're both sitting there watching the game, not knowing each other, but are both cheering for Brian on the field, so we started to talking. After the game was over, we all headed over to the bar for beers, and we hit it off. Brian later admitted to setting us up, as he felt sorry for us, as we were so old. We were 20. Our first real date night was a rabbit hunt. Back then, we all had CB radios, so the rabbit, which was me, would go park somewhere out in the bush and call in on the CB, and the hunters would have to find us. Well, I had found a perfect spot to hide. There was a newly dug dugout right beside the road, so we parked in it. Then I took the rake out of the trunk of my car and raked the tire tracks off the road so no one can see where we had parked. I think Susanne was having second thoughts about going on this date. The rest of the summer we spent together, riding inner tubes in the river, enjoying life and having fun. That summer ended and Susanne was off for more education at the University of Lethbridge, and neither one of us knew if this long-distance romance would last. We talked on the phone, no FaceTime back then, and saw each other over Christmas. But I was determined. On February 4th, I finished my day at work and drove the 10 hours from Grand Prairie to Lethbridge so that I could be there in the morning to surprise her when she woke up to help celebrate her 21st birthday. On July 31st, 1982, we got married at St. Mary's Church in Beaver Lodge. Some of you here were there for it. Some of the memories that stood out from that day, besides how beautiful of a bride she was 15 minutes late. I'm thinking, is she coming or what? Also, after we kissed and went to walk down the aisle out of the church, the heel of her shoe got caught in the old heating floor grate, and her dad came to the rescue and freed her shoe. Susanne was a strong person. When her son Stuart was born December 18th, there were some complications. It was very hard when they tell you they're flying the neonatal team in to take your son away from you and take him off to Edmonton. Stuart spent just about a week there on his own in Edmonton, as Susanne could not travel from having a C-section. Stuart came back to us on Christmas Eve with a little elf hat on. Susanne has commented that was the best Christmas present of all time. We spent time at Ronald McDonald House in Edmonton for Stuart's surgeries. Susanne would stay up for hours talking and consoling with other parents there to help them feel better and not alone. Susanne was more of a risk taker than I was. When the DJ business Party Sound came up for sale, she said, "You can do this." I was thinking, there is no way I'm going to stand up in front of 50 people and play music. I was way too shy. Well, she was right. We ran that company together for 30 years. Susanne also worked for 10 years as the director of the Peace Country Science Network, working with schools and teachers to help mold the minds of young Sheldon Coopers. Sometimes being married to a redhead can be a good thing. When we decided to build our house in Crystal Lake Estates, Susanne took on the job as general contractor and kept things on task. We dug the basement the long weekend in September, and we had our Christmas tree up with presents under it for December 24th. Sometimes you can affect a lot of people from a comment or a suggestion. I used to race motocross dirt bikes, and Susanne would usually be out there with me helping out. After Black Sunday 100-mile race, we were back at our house with our friends Ralph and his wife Pam. We were having some beers and talking about how much fun we had racing, and that it was sad that winter was coming and the riding would be done for the year. Susanne said, "Why does it have to be done? Can't you ride in the winter?" From that comment, the 24-hour Numbum ice race was born, which has raised thousands of dollars for charities like Camp Tamarack. And after 30 years, the race still continues. Susanne did love to travel. One year she said, "Let's spend Christmas in Roatan." I said, "Where is that and why?" She knew that I liked to scuba dive, and they had a dive program that Stuart could take to get certified also. We headed out for Anthony Key Dive Resort in Roatan, Honduras. We had a great time there, the people were great, and it was a beautiful country, and little did we know. A few years later, when Stuart graduated from high school, we were taken back to Anthony Key as his grad present. We were having a good time there and waiting for a taxi to take us into town. Stuart said, "Dad, look, there's a real estate office right here." So we popped in for a look, and like a good fish, the hook was set. Shortly after we got home, Susanne returned to Roatan on her own and bought us a place. A year later, we're loading up a sea can container with our worldly possessions and moving to Roatan. Susanne loved Roatan, the friendly people, the sea breezes, sandy beaches, and everything's green there, even in the wintertime. Susanne spent some time there alone as I went back and forth with work. People would often ask her, "Aren't you scared to be there all by yourself?" And she would comment that she felt safer there than in Grand Prairie. Besides her family, Susanne loved going camping at Dunvegan, swimming at the pool in Beaver Lodge, scrapbooking with the ladies, also sitting on the deck at our house. We would often stay up till after 11 o'clock listening to music and enjoying the beautiful summer Alberta nights. Susanne also had a love for big trucks, especially Kenworths. She kept saying, "I'm going to drive one someday." When my brother Alan and I and some of my Saskatchewan cousins were off for a motorbike trip, Susanne would go see who she called her Saskatchewan cousin. My cousin Ralph has a truck repair shop there, and they had a big six-wheel drive army truck in the yard. Susanne thought, "I want to drive that," but there was no way she could climb up into the cab. So my cousin Mike came up with the idea to put her in the bucket of the front end loader and lifted her up to the cab, and it worked. And she drove down that road in that big truck. Thanks, Mike. The last few years have taken its toll on her. Susanne has had 18 surgeries in the last 5 years, and every one of them took a piece of her. But the worst was when she lost the vision in her right eye and was no longer able to drive. She felt trapped. We would go for car rides just to get out of the house. The other weekend, we took a drive down to Dunvegan so that she could see all the colors of the leaves before they fell. Little did we know that would be the last time. We were planning a trip to Anacortes, Washington for April of 2019 to attend the big Tulip Festival, but now that will not happen. Like most couples, we had a one of these days list. One of these days we'll drive up the Alaska Highway. One of these days we'll take a European river cruise. One of these days we'll see Stuart get married. And now, God willing, one of these days, I will kiss her lips again.
Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away.
to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Yeah, when I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.